On day one, some more, we are joined by our political panel right now. Gentlemen, thanks for coming back. We appreciate it as always. Tim Rosales on the Republican side, president and CEO of the Rosales Johnson Agency, worked on a lot of political campaigns, and you were also working in D.C. during the impeachment of Bill Clinton for one of the House managers, Democratic side at Emerson, Democratic consultant, currently consulting for presidential candidate Michael Bloomberg. You were also working for President Clinton during the last impeachment.
Absolutely. All right. We were acquitted in that particular trial.
Introductions out of the way now. Your reaction, Tim, to day one on what happened in our nation's capital today?
Well, I don't think there were any surprises. Right. I went through a lot of process. Mm-hmm. Both sides kind of, you know, went through mm-hmm. a little bit of, you know, the procedures. I think the question is how many Americans were really tuning in today.
I was wondering that as well. I want to see the ratings.
that's going to be interesting to see. I think everybody, we've said this before, people have made up their minds. They kind of know what's going on. I think one thing to remember, though, with this is that it's not like a trial that you see in a courtroom. Mm-hmm. It's much different. Senate has different rules. This has, the Chief Justice who is presiding over the trial is really just a figurehead, and the Senate is in control. And right now, Republicans are in control of the Senate, much like they were back in during the Clinton impeachment. And there still is that adversarial relationship mm-hmm. between the House and the Senate. And I think you're seeing that play out, you know, this time, much like you did, you know, back in the Clinton impeachment.
Yeah, the Democrats were trying to subpoena witnesses today, and then the Republicans just completely voted that down. So this is pretty much where we're probably going to see days of just back and forth.
Right. Elections matter. Mm-hmm. Right. As often, right? So the Senate is currently a Republican mm-hmm. majority, and the House is a Democratic majority. Today is no surprise, as Tim said. The only sort of maneuvering was on Mitch McConnell's, you're going to do this in 2 days mm-hmm. With 24 hours, and the Dems were able somehow, or some Reaps were with him on that, were able to say, okay, get 3 days, which is going to be exhausting as it is, because this is my world. This is where I live, and I could hardly watch today.
Right.
It was the same thing over and over, buttle, rebuttal. Right? I mean, putting your argument down. And I thought the Dems did a good job. The extraordinary moment that we're living in this country right now is somebody's lying, mm-hmm. and we're all sure that it's the Reaps. And the Republicans and the base believes that it's all the Dems that are lying. And there's no maneuvering around
that. There's nobody in between right now.
No,
we are
none.
Split. And like we've talked about this every time you guys have come on the show, and you just said it. People aren't going to budge. You have your mind made up on where we're going right now. So while this is happening, the president is in Davos, Switzerland, mm-hmm. talking about the economy.
Right.
I believe he sent out one tweet today, last time I checked. It just said, read the transcripts. Do you think that this trip came at an opportune time for the president to get out of Washington while this is starting?
Oh, there's no question. Absolutely. When it heats up in Moscow, you go to the Bolshoi, right? When it heats up in Washington, D.C., you hit the road.
Okay.
You find some place to go, and you do something that people really like.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you sign a trade agreement, or you...
talk about the economy.
Talk mm-hmm. about the economy, mm-hmm. how well the economy is doing, things like that. And I think it's key to remember that this is about one person. This is about Donald Trump as president of the United States. Is he unfit to serve? And let's keep that focus on him long enough where we can catch him, you know, in one spot. I mean, he's a wily cat.
So why not, for Democrats, why not just wait this out? We got an election coming up in less than a year. Why not say, you know what, wait this out. You say elections have consequences.
Mm-hmm. Good question. Death by 1,000 cuts mm-hmm. is my response, which mm-hmm. is you keep coming at this guy.
Mm-hmm.
This guy is Teflon Don times 10. He is hard to knock down and keep him down. And I think you just got to keep coming back. I think the impeachment is going to highlight a number of issues where he committed crimes or committed a crime. I think that the American public is reminded of that. I think women are slowly trickling away from Donald Trump and from his base. I think he's going to have real women voter issues this fall.
Do you think that same that could have been said about Bill Clinton, though?
I think it could. But getting back to something mm-hmm. that, you know, Ed said, I think that right now we've got kind of the unique situation where the president doesn't have to say anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He's giving the House, and right now, you know, enough rope to hang themselves. And I don't think they're doing a particularly good job. Nancy Pelosi picked kind of the same guys, Adam Schiff, Jerry Nadler, these impeachment managers who didn't do such a great job when it was over in the House and really started turning, I think, independents and some of the American public kind of like, okay, is this really what we ought to be spending their time on? You know, we look at everything that Pelosi has been doing so far has been kind of a swing and a miss. Mm-hmm. I think she probably needs to call the Houston Astros and pick a few signs.
Oh, wow.
so that maybe she can get one, and put the ball into play. But right now, that's just not happening. So I think for the president, it's wise to kind of keep his mouth shut. I think that you let them go. And if I was a Democrat, I'd want to get this thing done as quickly as possible because they're not winning any converts, and you continue to see the president's approval ratings either stay stable or rise.
Well, you know what? Democrats want this to end quickly, the ones running for president, because this takes them off the trail before Iowa. And the man you're working for right now, Mike Bloomberg, that benefits him, that benefits Pete Buttigieg, and that benefits Joe Biden.
And Joe Biden is out there today in downtown Des Moines passing out oranges or something.
I mean, this is a crucial time, and a lot of these candidates have been asked by reporters, you know, how do you feel about this? And you know, it's my constitutional, you know, I need to be here to fight for the Constitution. This is my job. I have an obligation. I mean, Bernie Sanders came out and said, I'd rather be in Iowa right now. Yeah. You know, they all feel that way.
The caucus is a lot of work.
I love the politeness between you guys, by the way.
Pardon me. Do you have any grape poupon? Yeah,
I do. Yeah, okay, great. Part of the thing about a caucus is it's labor intensive. Mm-hmm. You have to make a decision to go, and then you have to go stand with a bunch of people that you don't know, and then you vote, and then if you don't reach a certain threshold, your candidate's out. Mm-hmm. And so I think the work that Cory Booker had a good operation, I'm not sure he bailed there, but Biden has got people on the ground, Bernie's got people on the ground. You know, those are intensive organizations that the candidate really needs to be there for. And I think you're right. I think those four are totally watching the TV and watching their iPhone, trying to figure out what to do next.
Yeah, they're suffering. And I think that, you know, that's really kind of the debate within the Democratic Party right now is, you know, the fact is that they don't really have a one candidate they're rallying around. Mm-hmm. They've got a new entrant, you know, Mr. Bloomberg coming into the race. You have right now, it looks like every front runner that the Democrats have is, you know, 70 years old, white, and not really any different than what they've offered in the past. And it is a far cry from this very diverse field that they had presented just a few months ago. And I think that a lot of Democrats strategists, you know, working on our side of things are looking at this and saying, we are missing a huge opportunity here with the cast of characters, no offense to anyone, that we're presenting as front runners here in this race, and you know, missing a huge opportunity when you've got and you had some pretty dynamic and diverse candidates, at the onset of this race. I don't know that they really know where they're going, mm-hmm. and I think we're seeing that with this impeachment trial as well. And you know, I don't think there's an end game to what Speaker Pelosi and others are doing.
It's the defaulting game, which is if nobody catches fire and mm-hmm. takes off like a rocket, we're going to have Joe Biden running down the trail. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's going to be Joe. He hasn't, his campaign is, he's not raising as much money as everybody else.
Right.
He doesn't have the field people on
he's
the ground.
He's just kind of hanging back a little bit, right?
And he doesn't do anything except mm-hmm. go out and make a mistake.
Right.
And
last debate, it was Warren and Bernie, who were kind of in the spotlight over the comment of a woman not being president.
Right.
So Biden's just kind of been hanging back.
And doing well.
Right.
Yep. And all the while, the president is living rent-free inside of all of their heads mm-hmm. right now. And I think that's a position where, you know, he wants to be in and his campaign wants to be in. And if I was them, I'd feel pretty good about where they are at this point.
And this impeachment conversation is going to continue after it wraps up, too, because the president's going to be like, look, we already know what he's going to say. Right. All they've tried to do, they accuse me of obstructing. They've been trying to obstruct me the entire time I've been here. And if the economy is good, he's going to hang his hat on that.
Right.
And like with President Clinton, you said it before, you know, we got, you know, acquitted, you know, with Clinton. And that's what he went into that election with. And I think that's going to be the same thing here with Trump, because I don't think there's any chance right now. I don't know what your thoughts are, but any chance that the Senate is going to
We know what's going to happen here.
Exactly.
And this is also going to trickle down into congressional races, too.
Sure.
This is going to be the message.
Absolutely. I think the Dems are in good shape this year. I really do. I think Trump is wounded. I think he's a flawed character that I think serious voters are going to take a look at and realize, you know, he made fun of John McCain, right? He called people that come from Mexico rapists. You know, we need to continue to bring those sorts of issues back up that question, bring question directly to his character, and is he fit to be president of the United States?
Well, meanwhile, the economy is going good. People are happy. You know, they're looking at their personal lives and kitchen table issues and saying, look, you know what, for me personally, for my family, you know, except maybe here in California because we've got our own set of California-generated problems, but everywhere else in the country, they're saying things are pretty good.
Got to get that one. Absolutely. I respect that totally.
Thanks. All right. Good job. Nice
gentlemen, job. Right. As always, we love having you on for Happy Hour.
Thank you. It's the best.
It's
very good.
And Emerson, Tim Rosales, we always appreciate your insight and your humor as well.
Thanks, and your respect.
Absolutely.
Yeah, no question. You guys don't fight, and I like it. I get a lot of questions. We like them because they have a discussion. You can actually understand.
He's one of the best guys.
You guys can disagree on policy, but you can shake hands, leave.
Oh, absolutely.
And no question.
Grab a drink.
No question. Or two.
Guys, thanks. Maybe we appreciate it. And we will continue to cover.